Hey, check this out. Capacitor is still parallel. And this is secondary assumption. Better diode there, same as before. A little better results out of the ball, but I don't know if it's not going to go any different. But check out this yellow wire here. This is what I'm using to short the diode out. Notice when the spark gap fluctuates, what it's doing. There's no wind here. Appears to be copper wire becoming electromagnetized. It's attracting towards something. I don't know why. There's no metal under there. There's wire for the, I guess the wire is for the outlet. No, it goes to the right. This outlet over here, the wire comes behind the wood here and it goes over that way. So there's no wires behind here for it to get the magnetic field. Somehow, I don't think it's repelling off of this one. It doesn't appear to be having any effect to this wire. This is the main power wire for the primary. But, so, obviously, we see quite pulses. Very little. Let's feel though. It shouldn't be enough to do that. I mean, why is that wire becoming magnetic? Obviously, current has to be flowing through it to produce a magnetic field. Maybe it works, but why is it only going to spark at this place? So if I take the gap all the way down, then we don't see it. When we bring it out, we get to start disrupting a little bit. You see a little tiny movement in it. And then when it's out really far, we see substantial jerking on it. But when I open the gap enough to where it just has to, when it fires, when the breakdown finally is achieved, you really see it pop. That diode wire. By the way, this thing has been chucking a piss out of it all night. I've been being pretty careful, I thought. Every time I turn it off, I short the camera cap. I short that thing off because it didn't have any parts. And I short these out, and this doesn't seem to work at all either. And I close the spark gap. And I'll go and try to adjust that damn thing. And I accidentally touched this side of the gap, the negative to the secondary, and something metal here, I don't know, probably the top, ground where it connected to it, but that buzz would be like, hell, that actually hurt, that felt like 120 got a hold of it, like it normally is, but, I felt my muscles contracting. Some of these wires here, like this yellow wire, it was completely off, I did all the process of shorting it, I wanted to touch that diode to pull it off of there, and I touched the flip right here on this side of it, and that buzzed the hell out of me. Yeah, I don't get it. This red wire got here to shorten the two electrodes in the cap that got me. It's just weird going on here. But that wire is interesting. It's inducing some kind of magnetic field on it, and I definitely get a lot better results on this ball. And before I had to turn the lights off, I didn't really see it. It's fairly bright. Getting the ball with the light on. That's pretty neat. I don't know where I'm going next here. I'm going to flip this check valve diode around and see if I get any different results that way. So, stay tuned for that.